Hospitality helps make up for the coldness outside. I'd like to take this opportunity, Your Majesty, to thank you for a piece of cutlery. It's a fine jeweled saber that I received as a gift from the Saudi Boy Scouts who visited the White House last year. And with the budget battle about to commence in Washington, it's going to come in very handy. King Fahd and the Saudi royal family, reflecting the values at the heart of their society, have been sharing and generous leaders. In addition to their humanitarian aid throughout the world, they contribute to such cultural and educational institutions as the American University in Beirut, for example. And closer to home, when fire destroyed a major cultural facility at Wolf Trap here in Washington, threatening to short-circuit an entire theatrical season, the Saudi embassy quickly located a huge tent and had it flown to Washington, and the show went on. In 1977, Terrasette Elementary School in Reston, Virginia, received a solar heating system dedicated by none other than our guest of honor this evening. King Fahd's exuberance for getting involved is well known. He's maintained the rich tradition of the Majlis, meeting directly with his people, listening to their ideas, as often as not, to their problems. This personal identification with his people has manifested itself in his avid support for Saudi Arabia's soccer team. And Your Majesty, I understand that you have, on occasion, gone so far as to call the coach and offer suggestions. Being a former radio sportscaster, I'd love to do that. However, in this country, they only permit me to call him after the game is over. But there's an Arab saying, the sands are blowing. And I submit to you, King Fahd, that if the sands of time give us any hint of the future, it is that in the days ahead, the friendship between the Saudi Arabian and American people will be a strong and vital force in the world, and that the future of the Middle East is one of peace. Your Majesty, it's been an honor for us to have you as our guest. I look forward to building on what we've accomplished today.
فخامة الرئيس
Mr. President
أيها الأصدقاء الأعزاء
Dear friends
من دواعي سروري في هذه الليلة
I am pleased indeed this evening
أن أستمع لهذه الكلمات القيمة
To hear these valuable words, these precious words
من صديق العزيز فخامة الرئيس ريغان.
From my good friend, His Excellency President Reagan.
وبهذه المناسبة الطيبة.
And on this good occasion.
أقدم تحياتي.
I would like to give my greetings.
إلى مس ريغان.
To Mrs. Reagan.
ولجميع الأصدقاء هنا مرة أخرى.
All the friends that are assembled here once again.
سررت كثير أن فخامة الرئيس
I was indeed happy when I heard the president
يتتبع الأمور الرياضية في المملكة العربية السعودية
is following the news of sports in the kingdom of Saudi Arabia
في الواقع مثل ما تفضل فخامة الرئيس
as a matter of fact just exactly as The president said,
هذا صحيح أني أنا أتتبع كذلك.
This is true because I follow the news of sports in my country.
ولذلك الفريق السعودي لكرة القدم.
And therefore the Saudi soccer team.
أخذ الدرجة الأولى في على دول آسيا.
Was first among all the Asian countries.
وأصبح المرشح الوحيد.
And became the first, the only candidate.
بالنسبة لما أقيم من دورة أولمبية في لوس أنجلوس.
As far as a candidate for the Olympic in Los Angeles this past summer.
حضر إلى لوس أنجلوس.
It came, the team, the Saudi soccer team came to Los Angeles.
ما توفق حتى ينتصر.
But it was not lucky enough in order to win any medals.
ولكن الأهم إنه رؤي في لوس أنجلوس واندل على شيء فهو يدل على المستوى الرياضي في المملكة العربية السعودية.
But the most important thing is that the team participated in the Los Angeles and it showed the world that Saudi Arabia care about athletics and sports.
ووجد كل الترحيب والاهتمام من هذا الشعب العزيز.
And the team found all kinds of reception and greetings from this good people in the United States.
وقبل شهرين كذلك.
And also a couple of months ago.
أخذ الكأس آسيا.
The team won the Asian Cup.
طبعا كانت في دول مارست الرياضة قبل أن تمارسها المملكة العربية السعودية بحوالي 100 سنة. هناك دول من دول آسيا مارست هذه الرياضة اللي
Among some Asian countries that have had soccer and practiced the game of soccer for 100 years before Saudi Arabia.
المملكة العربية السعودية مارست هذه الرياضة منذ 20 سنة أو أقل.
The Kingdom of Saudi Arabia took up soccer only about 20 years ago or maybe less.
وأخذت كأس آسيا.
And won the Asian Cup.
بجدارة.
Rightfully so.
طبعا أعتقد أن مثل هذه المباراة هي ما فيها مجاملة.
And of course, in such matches, there is nobody takes into consideration the good feelings of the other. You play to win.
حتى إنه إحدى الدول الآسيوية التي تبارت مع السعودية.
So much so that one of the Asian countries that played against Saudi Arabia.
قالت إن سوف تأخذ الكأس.
Said that they were their team was going to win the cup.
وحجزت كرسي للكأس والطائرة.
As a matter of fact, they even reserved a special desk on the plane for that cup.
نحن لم ندعي إنه سوف نأخذ الكأس.
We did not claim that we were going to win the cup.
ولكن أخذ الفريق السعودي كأسين.
But the Saudi team won two cups instead of one.
الكأس ال كأس أفريقيا.
The African Cup.
وأحسن لاعب حارس للباب في جميع الدول الأفريقية. أخذ أعطوه الكأس.
And also the goalie won the cup for the most valuable player or the best goalie in those games and tournaments.
طبعاً كنا فيما سبق قبل خمس سنوات نهزم.
Of course, in the past, only 5 years ago, we were always were defeated.
وبالفعل أنا تبنيت الرياضة.
As a matter of fact, I have adopted sports in my country.
ليس فقط كرة القدم.
Not only soccer.
ولكن العديد من الألعاب الرياضية.
But many other sports and athletics.
الآن يوجد عندنا 125 نادي رياضي.
Now we have 125 athletic clubs.
تشتمل على جميع أنواع الألعاب الرياضية بما فيها كرة القدم.
Those clubs practice all kinds of sports, including soccer.
فالمؤمل إن أي دورة عالمية نساهم فيها كذلك بجميع أنواع الألعاب الرياضية.
And we also hope that we would be able to participate in many international tournaments in the future.
وقبل أمس الفريق السعودي للناشئين اللي عمرهم 16 سنة.
The day before yesterday, the Saudi youth group, those who are under 16.
أخذ نعم أخذ الكأس للناشئين اللي عمرهم 16 سنة.
Won the cup for the youth under 16 years old.
وهذه مباراة سوف تقام في الصين في الشهر القادم.
And the tournament
لفرق آسيا ومن أفريقيا.
And the tournament for the Asian and African Games will be held in China next year.
وحيذهب الفريق السعودي ليعمل مباراة هناك.
And the Saudi team is going to go in order to play.
طبعا بنعتقد انه شيء جيد جدا.
And of course we think this is a very good thing.
ان يهزم الفرق الموجوده في اسيا ويذهب الى الصين ليتبارى مع الفرق اللي على نفس المستوى 16 سنه ولكنها مستوى جيد جدا.
That it has already defeated the similar teams in Asia and now it is going to China in order to defeat other more powerful teams.
كذلك هناك فريق لكرة القدم من اللي أعمارهم من 18 و 19 سنة.
Furthermore, there is another soccer team for those who are 18 and 19 year old.
سوف اجتاح اللي قبل من بقي أربع دول بيتبارى معها.
It has won all the tournaments and there are only four countries left that it is going to face.
نعتقد انه سوف نهزمها ان شاء الله.
And we believe that we are going to defeat those also.
هذا الفريق اذا انتهى من مع الاربع الفرق اللي سوف تقام هذه الدوره في للاربع الفرق في ابو ظبي.
When this takes place in Abu Dhabi in the United Arab Emirates and faces those four countries.
سوف يذهب الى موسكو.
It will go to Moscow.
لا نعرف هيكون يرجع شيوعي ولا لا.
We don't know whether the members of the team will come back as communists to us or not.
لكني مقتنع انه سوف يقابل ملايين المسلمين هناك.
but I believe that our team will meet millions of Muslims there in the
لكن نعرف هل يسمح العالم السعودي لأنه مكتوب فيه لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله.
I don't know whether the Soviets will allow the Saudi flag to flutter and to be raised because the wordings on the flag says there is no God but the God and Muhammad is his only prophet.
المهم أن نعمل مباراة في الصين في بكين وفي موسكو.
What is important that we are going to have matches in China and in Moscow.
هذا يدل على شيء يدل على مستوى الرياضة في السعودية.
If this proves anything, it proves that there is a level of sports. The level of sports in Saudi Arabia is rather good.
قبل أن أختتم كلمتي هذه المحدودة.
And in conclusion, before I finish what I have to say with these limited remarks,
أقدم مرة أخرى شكري الجزيل لفخامة الرئيس وحرم فخامة الرئيس وأصدقائي الأعزاء.
I would like to thank His Excellency, my friend President Reagan, and Mrs. Reagan, and all my dear friends assembled here.
ولا أعرف هل يعلم فخامة الرئيس إنه يعمل الآن في السعودية. أكثر من 500 شركة أمريكية.
I don't know whether His Excellency the President realizes that at the present there are some 500 American companies working in Saudi Arabia doing business.
إذن هذا يدل على شيء، فهو يدل على الصداقة المتينة بين الشعبين كذلك.
If this is of any indication, it also indicates the close ties of friendship that exist between our two countries.
وكذلك اللجنة السعودية الأمريكية.
And furthermore, the Saudi American Commission
قامت بواجبها.
Did its duty.
وتعقد مرة في السعودية والمرة الأخرى في أمريكا.
And it holds its meetings regularly, once in Saudi Arabia and once in the United States.
بصفة دورية.
وفي
الواقع أني أقدم شكر الجزيل للمسؤولين في اللجنة سواء كانوا من السعوديين أو من الأمريكان.
I would like to take this opportunity to express my gratitude for the officials in this commission, whether be they Americans or Saudis.
لأنهم أنجزوا الكثير من المشاريع المهمة.
Because they have accomplished many of the important projects.
وكذلك الشركات التي ساهمت في إنجاز الأعمال الكبيرة وهي شركات أمريكية.
And also those companies that contributed greatly to our progress and among them many American companies.
إذن بين البلدين مستويات جيدة جدا إن كانت من الناحية السياسية أو الاجتماعية أو الاقتصادية فهي روابط قوية جدا.
Therefore, what I would like to say that there are several, many levels of relationships between our two countries, be they political, economic, or social. They all indicate the strong ties of friendship between our two countries.
فعندما نحتاج إلى أي نوع من ما تنتج الولايات المتحدة، إن كانت تكنولوجيا أو خلافها، معناها إنه نحن في حاجة إلى هذا الشيء.
When we need, when we are in need of any product that is produced by the United States, be it in the field of technology or otherwise, that means we are in need of this and we will work to get it.
وأستطيع أن أقول أنه نحصل على الأشياء اللي نريدها لأن معروف أنه بلد صديق للولايات المتحدة.
The reason we try to acquire these things because we consider ourselves as friends of the United States.
نحن في الواقع نريد السلام والاستقرار لمنطقة الشرق الأوسط.
Our aim, of course, is to see we want peace and stability for our region in the Middle East.
ونريد أن يعيش الجميع بسلام.
And we want for all people to live in peace.
نسيت أن أذكر شيء مهم جدا وهو أنه يوجد لنا العديد من الآلاف أبنائنا. يدرسوا في جامعات الولايات المتحدة حوالي 13,000 طالب.
I forget to mention something important earlier, and that is that we have about 13,000 of our sons that are studying in American colleges and universities.
ويجدون المعاملة الطيبة جدا.
And they all find a very good treatment.
منهم يمكن ناس موجودين هنا ودرسوا في الولايات المتحدة.
Some of them هنا في هذا المكان.
لابد في بعض منهم.
I'm sure that some of them are probably who have studied in the United States and they are here this evening.
أبنائي الكبار درسوا في الولايات المتحدة.
My sons studied in the United States.
أربعة.
Four of them.
وأخذوا الشهادة ال BA.
And they received their BA degrees.
من الجامعات الأمريكية.
From American universities.
بقي عبد العزيز لما يكبر شوي يروح الجامعة.
And I have now my young عبد العزيز, Prince عبد العزيز, when he is older, he will go to a university.
إذا اللي رصيد هنا في الولايات المتحدة بالنسبة أن أبنائي تخرجوا من الولايات المتحدة.
Therefore, I have an interest here in the United States because my sons graduated from American colleges and universities.
فأأمل أن تدوم هذه الصداقة.
I hope that this friendship will continue.
لأنها بنيت على أسس وقواعد متينة.
Because it was built on firm and sound foundations.
وختاما أحيي فخامة الرئيس و مس ريغن وجميع الأصدقاء وأهلا وسهلا بمن أراد أن يزور المملكة العربية السعودية من هؤلاء الأصدقاء.
And in conclusion, I would like to thank President Reagan and Mrs. Reagan again and all my friends here. And I would like for anybody who wishes to visit Saudi Arabia, you're all welcome to come and see my country.
وفي هذه اللحظة.
And at this moment.
أوجه الدعوة لفخامة الرئيس في أي وقت يجد عن عنده إمكانية زيارة المملكة العربية السعودية ومس ريغن.
I would like to invite President Reagan and Mrs. Reagan for any time if they wish to come and visit Saudi Arabia, they will find a friendly people there to welcome them.
Thank you very much.
help.
Listen. I think tonight, Montserrat Caballe and her accompanist, Fernando Torina, she has done so much for opera, and now here she so graciously and beautifully shared her talent with all of us, and I think for all of you, you will agree, we owe her a most heartfelt thanks for a very enchanted evening. Thank you.
Thank you.
Foreign Minister.